All right, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. My name is Manu. I'm the tech evangelist at Frosmo. I'm the only one basically standing in between you and your lunch, so I will be brief. As you can see, there's not many things that ever stood between me and my lunch, so I won't stand between you and yours for very long either. What we're talking about today is Frosmo, and we're a Finnish company that works in the e-commerce space. What I wanted to share with you is why we created Frosmo, why this company exists. And if I only had one slide, I would use this to explain it. It is, we see this problem all the time where you, whether it is in marketing or in the business development area or whatever part of the company that is not technical, finds itself struggling to get the things done that they want. The combination of business and IT is still, frankly, quite difficult. And so even though you have the best of ideas about how to grow your business, it is oftentimes very difficult to put that into practice. Because the reality of it is that it's more like this. So you have an idea and you're presented that, well, we can do this, but it will take half a year because we have our own roadmap of IT projects and it is very difficult to do. Something that you think is very simple. And so we think that this should be made easier, and so we did. We created a solution to this problem called Frosmo. It is a software as a service platform that once you insert a very small JavaScript snippet into your site, you can make any changes on your website. We've seen that it is, in fact, often a 10 times faster way of developing your site than what you have at the moment. And at this stage, usually people go, so you're telling me that you can develop things 10 times faster and I can make any changes on my site? I don't believe you. Ron Burgundy style. That's normal. This is the process we've all gone through, even I, before I joined the company. It sounded like this is not possible. And some of our clients have also gone through the same stages of disbelief and saying, I actually don't. I did not believe half of what we were promising to be able to do. But after working with us, they realized that actually what we say is actually possible. In 22 seconds, the way we do it is that normally everything is slow because you have to interact with the back end. And that's what's happening on normal sites. With Frosmo, we move the development of the site into the browser. And using JavaScript, you can make any changes. And this means that you're not limited by your IT systems, but simply by what you're trying to do and what you want to do. The way we do this is that because we have everything that happens in the browser, so imagine that your visitor sees the website. On top of it, imagine a layer where we are basically using data to analyze the content of the site, and then using a very simple JavaScript tag, move things around. Whatever is in the back end doesn't really matter. Like, you could be running it with a CMS or a CRM. And by the way, in e-commerce, you have so many different systems integrated. We just come literally one step on top of that. And even if you're running your back end with something that's called Nobody Knows, it's just there, or you have Magic Elves, which is fairly popular these days as well, we don't care. What we care about is, can we actually make those changes in the front end directly visible to the user? It makes it much faster to try out ideas and find out what works and what doesn't. Some of the companies that we work with actually use this method just to test out ideas and figure out what is the best way of doing things before setting up a longer IT project to implement them. But that speed is necessary because the market is moving very fast. And so, one of our clients told us this lovely story where the marketing managers from all these different areas, it was a travel company, marketing managers of all these different areas were coming back to the e-commerce director and saying, hey, thank you so much for putting that ski trip on the front page. And then on the same day, you have another marketing manager coming and say, hey, thanks so much for putting the beach holidays on the front page. Seriously, and this happened a couple of times over, and in fact, all they were seeing was different versions of the same site at the same time that we're optimized by Frosmo to show personalized content to those individuals. Something like that is super easy to do because we have very powerful segmentation tools built in. And so what Frosmo allows our partners to do is to develop their services 10 times faster. Finally, you can become customer-centric. So we've seen this also all the time. People talk about, hey, we want to be customer-centric. We want to focus in on the customer and their needs and what they want. But it's very difficult because our IT systems are so inflexible. Finally, when you actually remove that barrier, you can start thinking about how your customers are doing things, and you can implement changes and test things out at the speed that they are moving at and not the IT. And then finally, what we've also seen is that a lot of the organizations that we work with have changed their mentality around how they organize themselves, so that now that the IT department, if you will, who are looking after long-term projects and long-term implementation of technology, aren't anymore sort of fighting for the right to do that work, which is necessary, with the marketing and business people who want to drive the website or the service in a particular direction. And instead, they can find that, well, we can actually work together really nicely because we disambiguate the difficult back-end stuff from what's happening in the front-end. We're a company based in Helsinki, Finland. We have about 70% market share in Finland and in the Nordics, which means that right now we are expanding into the rest of Europe. So we're in a hyper-growth phase, so we're acquiring customers all the time everywhere across Europe and Southeast Asia. We're founded in 2008, but did this pivot towards e-commerce back in 2011. You may recognize some of the people we work with in Europe. Customers from Finland, obviously, that's pretty much 70% of business-to-consumer sales are somehow Frosmo optimized or magicalized. And in Europe, these are big brands that you may recognize. The reason why you haven't heard of us is that we're kind of an invisible partner. We are on the site, and the moment you actually get the site, well, we've already done our work, and you see normally a personalized site that is targeted towards what we know about you, possibly. And so this is it. I was given 15 minutes because of some, we had a scheduling mishap and we've been running over, so I thought I'd do this super fast. Thank you for your time. And by the way, before you clap, is there time for questions? Look, there's 7 minutes left. I did it in 8. Look at that. You can ask questions now if you want, and you can do it also in Spanish because we have Luis Lopez there who will speak Spanish. Alternatively, if you need to go and have your pinchos and breakfast or whatever it is that you're eating at this stage, we're also at a stand over there. You can see us looking good by the pallets. So unless we have an immediate question, yes, please. How does it work with PrestaShop? Have we worked with PrestaShop? Yeah, no, it's...
to that, so we can work with any platform. Yeah.
Yeah. So we don't have a PrestaShop module that is ready because you don't really need that. Our script goes into the header of the site, and after that, everything is done in our web UI. So you can replace elements, create segments, make any kind of modifications, preview them how they look before you actually launch it on the site. Another important thing to know is that we always, for any kind of modifications we make, we use 10% of traffic that see the original site. So for any particular thing that you may test or try, you will always have a control group that sees the original version of the site. Because on the back end, nothing changes. So insofar as you are concerned, you're still serving the same site as always, but it's the users who are seeing different versions of it in the browsers. Any other questions? No? Great. Come and visit us over there. Thanks for your time, guys.